Okay, so good evening, everyone. Today we have with us Mrs. Meena Sundaram. Good evening, ma'am. Ma'am obtained her MSc in mathematics from Central College, Bangalore, and started her career as a banker and worked for 25 years. However, she was always passionate about music. She did her MA in Carnatic music from Tamil Nadu. Further, she did diploma in Sangeeta Shastra and Music Appreciation from Sharada Kala Kendra, Bangalore. She continuously tries to keep herself updated on the subject and in appreciating the nuances of this art. So, as I was saying, ma'am is not just a performer, but she has also presented a research paper on rag ras, confluence of food and South Indian music, a rather interesting topic at the International Conference on Culture and Food, Literature and Society, Goa. He is passionate about teaching and sharing of India's rich tradition of musical art, Carnatic music, and is always open to new ideas and implementation of the same in teaching this art. He is a mentor for Shruti Saundarya, a group of like-minded classical singers who have performed for World Music Day at Kala Academy and at temples during various festivals. Apart from that, ma'am has also conducted lecture demonstrations on topics like Sangam, meeting point of Carnatic and Hindustani music, Bharat Ratna M.S. Subbalakshmi, a legend on her birth centenary, comparative study of Carnatic and film music for laymen, etc. Today, ma'am will enlighten us on the topic, exploring the different facets of Sri Muthuswami Dikshitar through his compositions, and will take us on a time travel along with him to different places through his kritis. Ma'am, we are honored to have you. Over to you, ma'am.
Namaskaram to everyone here. Very happy to be here. Even though it's a pandemic, it's nice to be meeting, even if it's online, it's nice to be meeting everyone here with the topic being music. So can you put the slide, please? Yes. So today the topic of discussion will be Nadajyoti Sri Muthuswami Dikshitar. As we go through his various songs, visiting along with him various kshetras, the temples, we will see, come to know what sort of a genius he is. So we'll start now first from the Trinity. A few words about the Trinity before I start on Muthuswami Dikshitar. Next slide, please. One cannot think of Carnatic music without the contribution of the Trinity. The Trinity, all three were born in Tiruvarur. The saying goes that birth in Tiruvarur and death in Kashi helps the soul to attain moksha. All these three composers, that is Saint Tyagaraja, Sri Shama Shastri, as well as Muthuswami Dikshitar, all were blessed by some divine powers. So the common thread in the music was, of course, bhakti personified, and also there was a mix of bhava, raga, and tala. Or you could also say laya in their music. Next slide, please. So Muthuswami Dikshitar was born on 24th March 1775 in Tiruvarur. He's the youngest of the Trinity and who has traveled the most. He's a vocalist as well as a vayanika, and his compositions, we see there is no verse for personal grievances. At the most, he uses mamava or pahima. Next slide, please. So when he was young, he traveled along. Next slide, please. When he was young, he traveled along with his father and other two brothers and sister to Manali, because his father was then invited to Manali at the behest of Muthukrishna Mudaliar and later Venkatakrishna Mudaliar. So being in Manali, and also Venkatakrishna Mudaliar was associated with the East India Company, he had a lot of chance to visit Fort St. George, where the Western band used to play, and he was exposed to Western music. We see this when he was, this was when at a very young age. So he was able to absorb this music and he has produced what is known as the Notaswara at a later stage. So at this very young age, listening to this Western music, he was able to absorb in all the music, which he later put it into form in a form of Notaswara. About 38 to 40, he has composed Notaswara. So while in Manali, the Chidambaranatha Yogi once visited them at their house. On seeing Muthuswami Dikshitar, he was very much impressed. So with the permission of his father, he took him along to Kashi. So we will see what the influence of Kashi had on Muthuswami Dikshitar. Next slide, please. In Kashi, along with Chidambaranatha Yogi, he was initiated into Sri Vidya, Upadesha of the Mantra, and also Tantric form of worship. And here it was here that in Kashi, he was able to hear a lot of North Indian music, that is Hindustani music. So at this young age, he absorbed a lot of this music. And it is said along with Chidambaranatha Yogi, he was able to visit even up till Badrinath. So that is why we have a number of compositions of his, starting from Brahmeshwaram up till Badrinath. The full range of compositions are there on different kshetras on the way. So next slide, please. So once he finished the Upadesha, mantras and training under the Chidambaranatha Yogi, it is said that he had a dip in the Ganges, and then while rising from the Ganges, he received the Veena. This is supposed to be the Veena of Muthuswami Dikshitar. What is unique about this Veena is the Yali is faced upwards, whereas all the other Veenas have got the Yali faced downwards. This particular Veena has got the Yali above. So we see in his composition, lot of this, since he is also a Vainika, we see a lot of Dhammakas pertaining to Veena in his compositions. Then on his return from Kashi, next slide please. He returned of course to Manali and of course to meet his parents, and from there the first Kshetra which he visited was Tirthani temple. So it was here, it is another legend goes that when he was at Tirthani temple, he was meditating there for 41 days. At the end of 41 days, it is said an elderly gentleman came and put a piece of candy in his mouth. And with that, he started composing. So his first composition is Sri Nadadi Guru Guha in the Raga Maya Mala Gaula. He has chosen Sanskrit as his language in all his kritis. His mastery over this language can be seen in his kritis. The free flow of the words and the marvels of his musical architecture. He has also composed what is known as the Samudaya Kritis, that is group songs, but on a particular theme, which has about 5 or up to 9 number of songs in it. So for example, we see his Guruguha Kritis, his Kamalamba Navavarnam, his Abhayamba, Panchabhuta Kritis, Panchalinga Kritis, Navagraha Kritis, Ganapati Kritis and Nilotpala Navavarna, just to state a few. Next. So from Tiruthani later, he travelled up to Tiruvaru, Tiruvaru Kshetra. We will see what is important about this Kshetra Tiruvaru. Next slide, please. So the importance of Tiruvaru, first of all, it is home to the trinity of Carnatic music, Shama Shastri, Saint Tyagaraja, as well as Sri Muthuswami Dikshitar. Here, there is also a temple on Sri Tyagaraja Swami, and the chariot here is supposed to be the largest in Asia. This comes around the main streets of Tiruvaru during the festival. Of course, the Kamalalayam, the temple tank, is also very famous. And also here, even now till date, some unique musical instruments are played in the temple, like the Panchamukha Vadyam, the Shuddha Madalam, and the Bari Nagaswaram. Next slide. We can see, just have a glimpse of the scene. So this is the chariot which is there, which goes through the town during the festival. This is the Kamalalayam. This is the Panchamukha Vadyam. Even now, it is still played in Tiruvaru during festivals. Tiruvaru is another place where he has composed a number of kritis on Lord Ganesha. So this is one of them. This is in the Raga Natanarayani. So I will just sing for you this, then give a little bit of explanation on the same. Mm-hmm. गणपते पालय शुमामग गणपते पालय शुमामायामय वल्लभपते श्रीमग गणपते पालय महानटनारायणी नंदन मानित देव देवकी नंदन मानित देव देवकी नंदन महेश्वर गुरुगुण भक्त चंदन मादंग वदनेन्द्रारि वंदन मग गणपते पालय. So here we see Dikshitar has added his own composer mudra, that is Guru Guha, as well as the Raga mudra, Natanarayani. So this is one unique piece in the Raga, very rare Raga, Natanarayani. We'll go to the next Kriti. This is a very common Kriti in the Raga Gaulai. So we will see what is special about this. In some of his Kritis, Dikshitar has added a folklore into his music. By learning certain words, we come to know that this part of the Kriti has taken the folklore and we come to know of it. So we will see what is the folklore. I'll just sing a few lines of this song so that we'll come to know more about this. काम जनक देवेन्द्र संयुक्त कमलालय तट निवासो काम जनक देवेन्द्र संयुक्त कमलालय तट निवासो कोमलधर पल्लव बगयुग कोमलधर पल्लव बगयुग गुरु गुह ग्रह शिवात्म जग कोमलधर पल्लव बगयुग गुरु गुह ग्रह शिवात्म जग. So in this Anupallavi we see he has stated where the temple of this Ganesha is situated, that is the Kamalalaya Tatanivaso, it is on the banks of the Kamalalaya. His own mudra Guru Guha is entwined Komalagara Pallava Padakara Guru Guha Shivatma Jaga, that is that. So we see in the Anupallavi he has given some details of the thing. Next we'll go to the Charana.
Supanakashana Vitnarajo Padambudo Gauravana Vasanadaro Balachandro Naragirudha Nambhodaro Kubalaya Swavisharna Pashangosha Modako प्रकाश करो भव जलधि नाहो ओ प्रकाश करो भव जलधि नाहो मूल प्रकृति स्वभाव सुख करो.
So I'm just taking a little part of the charana because here I want to explain what is the meaning of suvarna akarshana. Akarshana means to attract. There's another meaning for that. Akarshana means to scratch. So what is the story behind it? It is said that Sundaramurti Nayanar was at Kivalur worshipping Lord Shiva over there. And he wanted some gold for making jewelry for his wife Paravai Nachiya. It is said that Kivalur, Lord Shiva gave him some golden bricks and he didn't want to carry it to Tiruvaru. So it is said that he put it in the tank in Kivalur and it is said that Lord Shiva instructed him that he could collect the same at Tiruvarur Kamalalayam tank. So when he came to Tiruvarur, he took the golden bricks from the Kamalalayam tank and he took it to the goldsmith. So when he went to the goldsmith, they told that this brick is not pure gold. So he was very much astonished and then again he begged to Lord Shiva, like, how come you have put me down? And So at this particular time, Lord Shiva is said to have sent Ganapati in the form of an Achari, it is a goldsmith. So when he came there, when he came along with the other goldsmiths of the temple, and it is said that when he scratched the golden brick, it is said it, the other goldsmith were astonished that it was the purest form. So this is the story behind Suvarna Akarshana. So just want to know how he has woven even the lot of legend or lore at that particular time. This must have happened somewhere in the 8th century. Sundaramurthy Nayara was around the 8th century. But even that story must have been around, and he has woven this story into this script. So next we'll go to the next kriti is Siddhivinayaka. So if we come to this kriti, very common one, and everybody must have heard this. It is in the raga Chamaram. Chamaram is also known as Shanmugapriya. And here it is said that this kriti was not composed on any particular deity, but it is for the Chaturthi festival. Because we Lord see how he, in the Charanam, he tells how and when the festival, Chaturthi festival, is conducted.
भाद्रपदमास चतुर्थ्या ब्राह्मणादि पूजितम् भाद्रपदमास चतुर्थ्या ब्राह्मणादि पूजितम् पाशाघोषधरं चत्र च मरवरीजितम् भाव रहितं दास जन हृदय विराजितं रौहिणेयनुजाचितं इयन वरजितं.
So this is the part of the charanam which I am singing. So we see when Chaturthi is conducted, Bhatra Padamasa Chaturthya Brahmanadi Pujitam. So many musicologists feel that this composition is mainly composed for the festival Chaturthi. Next slide, please. This is a very common kriti. Most of the students of music are taught that it's Ganesha. Mostly, this is the first song which is taught to them.
महादेव सुतं गुरु गुहनुतं मारकोटि प्रकाशं शरदं महाकाव्य नाटकादि प्रियं महाकाव्य नाटकादि प्रियं मूषिक वाहन मोदक प्रियं महागणपतिं.
So here Anupallavi, or it is also called Samishti Charana. He has woven his mudra, Guru Guha. You see the Raga Mudra, he has used it in Nataka, Mahakavya Nataka Vipriyam. So the word Natin is imbibed in that sentence. Next, we'll go to the next Kriti, please. A very famous composition of Dikshitar, Vatapi Ganapati. The charanam, if you see, it is very descriptive. It gives a lot of information from the top to the bottom, what Ganesha has in his hand, to other details. So here we see Ganesha. He also sings as Lord Ganesha to be present in all the divine places, which is very evident from the fact that whichever Hindu temple you go to, there is always a sannidhi for Lord Ganesha. And this will be the first sannidhi you pray to even before entering the prakara. So one easily sees that is the best invocation song he has composed, and it salutes the main deity. So I'll just sing the last two lines of the charanam, which gives the Guru Guha Mudra as well as the Raga Mudra.
हरणि गुरु कुवतोषित बिंबं हंसत्वनि भूषित हेरंबं वातापि गणपतिं
Next slide, please. So these were just a very brief introduction to the different types of Ganapati Kritis which he has composed. There are more than around 16 compositions he has composed, all in Tiruvaru itself. Some are in Tiruvaru, some are there on the banks of Kaveri also. Now we come in Tiruvaru. We'll come to the main deity Kamalamba, on whom he has composed the Navavarna Kritis. So here in each of the Kritis, he gives the details of the Sri Chakra. The particular Avarnam and which I am going to sing, it is the Sarvasha Paripuraka, that is fulfills all expectations. For each chakra, he has composed the Kritis. There is also a Mangala Kriti as well as one first Kriti on Ganesha. So totally there are about 11 Kritis are there. Next slide, please. This is the Yagesha, the temple, and of course Kamalamba. Next slide, please. We'll go to the Kriti directly. So this is the Kriti. It is set to Radha Kalyani.
Kamalam Baba Jare Re Manasa Kamalam Baba Jare Re Manasa Kalpita Maya Kalaryam Yajare Kamala Baba Jare Re Manasa Kalpita Maya Kalaryam Yajare Kamala Bajare Kamala Vani Se Vita Parashwa Kamala Vani Se Vita Parashwa Radanam Gamaniya Radanam Kamala Varanam Kamalam Baba Jare. Sarvasha Paripu Prakachakre Swami Parama Shiva Kamini Savasha Paripurya Chakre Swami Parama Shiva Kamini Dhuva Sajita Gupta Yogini Loka Dvamjini Hamsini Nirvana Nija Sukha Pradana
Navavarnam in Kalyani, and here he has incorporated the Raga Mudra as well as his own composer Mudra. Next slide, please. So, coming to his Samudaya Kritis or group Kritis, he has composed on the Navagraha, Surya Murti on the Sun in Saurashtra Raga, Chandram Bhaje in Asaveri on Moon, Angarakam, Mars, then Budhamashriyami, Mercury, Natakuranji, Brihaspati, Jupiter, and Atana, Sri Chukram on Venus, in Parasraga, Divakara Tanujam, Saturn, Yatukula Kambodhi, Smaramyaham, and Mahaswaram. So if you see, he started actually with Brihaspati, Jupiter, because one of his disciples had severe stomachache. So with that, looking at his horoscope, he thought that it should be best that he composed in the to Jupiter. So, and he was, the disciple was asked to sing the same for 41 days, one mandala. And on completing the mandala, he was cured of his stomachache. It is said that after this, he started composing on all the other grahas also. So that is how we have got the Navagraha Kritis of Jupiter. Next slide, please. From this Kriti, Sindaraga, Dvijavanti, from this Kriti, we see the influence of his staying in Kashi. So in Kashi, in North India, we have a raga called Jai Jai Vanti. So this is similar to that. It is named as Dvijavanti. So here I wanted to bring to the point, like when Dvijadhar visits certain temple, how he observes everything, what is there, what type of festival, what are the instruments played. So here we see, we come to know what are the instruments played in this particular temple.
Yammari sambhavate janardananute dvijavanti raganute jalli madala jajarva ಮುದಿತೆ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಪ್ರದೇ ಅಖಿಲ ದೇಶ್ವರಿ.
ಸೊ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವಾದ್ಯ ಈಸ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್. ಜಲ್ಲಾರಿ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಏನ್ಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಬೈ ದ ಸೇಜಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅಗಸ್ತ್ಯ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿವೋಷನಲ್ ರೆಂಡರಿಂಗ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಪೂಜಾ. ಇನ್ ದ ಸುಬ್ರಹ್ಮಣ್ಯ ಸಹಸ್ರನಾಮಂ An invocation on Goddess Ambika, it says, Jallari Vadya Supriyaya Namaha. So here, Ambika, the celestial connoisseur of Jallari, Dvijadhar in this Kriti hails that Sannidhi Kaikaryam. That is, in the Sannidhi, certain Kaikaryams and offers are made, like musical offers also. In some temples, if the deity is in the Yoga Mudra, no Nadaswaram, anything else is played in the temple. But in this case, when she heard the two people, that is Sheshayya and Subbayya, one playing on the veena, another on the jallari, and also singing together, the devi was so impressed with the music that she came in the dream of that part of the ruler of that period, and fully decorated in all her jewels, saying that, instructing him to allow them to sing in their inner prakara also. So even now, under this divine decree, this instrument came into the inner sannidhi, and the practice even now continues. So this we get to know about the instruments played in different temples. Next slide, please. Now we come to Thiruvayaru. Thiruvayaru is the land of five rivers, and here the goddess is Dharma Samvardhini, and it is Panchanadeshwar. The lord is Panchanadeshwar. So it is said that Dikshadhar came to Thiruvayaru, and he composed on Dharma Samvardhini. And also when Saint Tyagaraja came to know that Dikshadhar has come to Thiruvayaru, by that time Dikshadhar's kritis have spread all over the place, and he had become quite famous. Tyagaraja also wanted to invite him to his place. So we will see two kritis which is sung by Dikshadhar in Thiruvayaru. Next slide, please. This is in the raga on goddess Dharma Samvardhini. It is in the raga Madhyamavati.
Madhav sodari sodari Madhyamavati Shankari, Madhav sodari sodari Madhyamavati Shankari, Madhurya Vajrumbini Mahadeva Kutumbini, Sadhu Jana Chitranjani Shashvata Guru Guha Janani, Bodharupini Niranjani Bhuvaneshadurita Bhajani, Padaja Vishwavilasini Panjanari Sholasini Vedashasta Vishwasini Virihari Hara Prakashini Dharma Samvardhini.
So here Shankari, Vijambini, Kutumbini, Janani, Vanjani, Niranjani. So these are all the terms. We can see his mastery over the Sanskrit language. In this Charanam itself, he has used the different combination of words. So from this, we know how well versed he was in Sanskrit. So next, we'll go to the next composition, which he also sang in Thiruvayaru. It is said that Saint Tyagaraja was having a festival in his house. And of course, his Ishta Daivata was Lord Rama. And he invited Bodhiswami Dikshadhar to his puja that day. And it is said that this particular kriti was composed by him during that visit to Saint Tyagaraja.
Chatra chamara kara drita ba భరతల బలశ త్రుగ్న విభీషణ సుగ్రీవ ప్రముఖాది సేవిత అత్రి వశిష్ఠజ అనుగ్రహ పాత్ర దశరథ పుత్ర మణిరంగవల్యలంకృత నవరత్న మండపేయ విచిత్రమణిమయ సింహాసనే సంసిద్ధ సుచరిత్ర పరమ పవిత్ర గురుగుహ మిత్ర పంకజ మిత్ర వంశశుధాముని చంద్రమేతిని పాల రామచంద్రమా మవ పయడ మహూతి సూత
సో హియర్ ఇఫ్ యు సీ దిస్ సాంగ్ మామా పట్టాదిరామ యు ఫైండ్ దట్ ఇస్ అ కంప్లీట్ పిక్చర్ ఆర్ అ పెయింటింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద పట్టాభిషేకం. So it gives a completely descriptive picture of the Pattabhishekam, who were all present, who were there, who did the chamaram, and full details are there. So, and also if you see the Sanskrit part of it, the grammar, here you see he has used a lot of importance on the word chatra chamara shatrughna vibhishana sugriva prampadal sevita atri vasesa putra maniranga vatra. Importance has given to that alphabet over here. Suchitra, Parama Pavitra, Guru Guha Mitra, Pankaja Mitra. So you see again the Sanskrit he has used, but in a very different way. But it gives us a complete picture of the Pattabhishekam. So it must have been very pleasing also. I'm imagining Tyagaraja inviting Dikshidhar and him presenting a picture of the Pattabhishekam musically. What would be the effect over there? So here. Guru Guha Mitra, so the composer's mudra is over there. Another, if anybody can make out where the raga mudra has been imbibed into this, can anybody guess where it is there? Any of the students can tell me, because you know, so many times I have showed you in all these kritis where the raga mudra was there. In this also raga mudra is there, but he has so woven it so well that you have to look for the mudra, but it has woven very well into this. So here if you see, Mani Maya Simhasane. So that Mani Rangu he has it. Now.
త్రి వశిష్ట అనుగ్రహ పాత్ర దశరథ పుత్ర మణిరంగ వల్యాలంకృత.
సో దట్ ఈస్ వెర్ హి హస్ వోవెన్ ద రాగా నేమ్ మణిరంగ, అండ్ ఆల్సో ఇట్ గివ్స్ అ వెరీ ఇమాజిన్ పిక్చర్. జస్ట్ ఇమాజిన్ సింహాసన్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఫుల్ డెకరేటెడ్ with lot of gems. So that sort of the picture it gives. Another thing is Rama is supposed to belong to the Vamsha. Here it says Guru Guha Mitra Pankaja Mitra Vamsha. So where does it show that he belongs to Surya Vamsha? If you see the Pankaja Mitra, if you take the term Pankaja Mitra, that is the Surya is the friend of Pankaja. That is when the sun comes, the lotus automatically blooms. So here, instead of saying directly Surya Vamsha, he says Pankaja Mitra Vamsha. So that is the sort of intricate things which he brings out. And we can get to know more about his Kriti, even not singing, but even by studying his Kritis, we can get a lot of information. Next song, please. So from Tiruvayaru, now we travel to Tinnalveli. So Tinnalveli, there's a very unique song on Goddess Kantimati. And the Lord is of course Nelliyappar. It's a very huge temple complex and a very beautiful one too. And there is a even there is a mandapam which has got a lot of musical pillars, and even the saptatalas are engraved on the floor or the roof on the temples, one of the mandapams over there. So now we come to the Hemavati. This is on Sri Kantimati. You will see how Dishadhar has used the words in this. So here how he describes Kantimati is very interesting. Here he says the face is in the form of the mystic Bijakshara, Kree. So this is a very unique description of the goddess. So and also it is said Tamara Barni Tadastitam. That is, the temple is situated on the banks of the Tamara Barni river. That is so, that is Shuddha Tamara Barni. That is, which is crystal clear Tamara Barni. And also she has Abhishekam is made from 108 conches, Shankha Shatyotara Sahasra Kalasha Abhishekam. So that is the thing. So this song is also sung during, suppose there is a Shatyadhapurti or a Sadabhishekam for any couple, and when they do the Abhishek, this particular song is sung and very appropriate for the occasion also. Next slide, please. From Tinnelveli, we travel to Guruvayur, where Guruvayurappan resides in Guruvayur. So in this composition, it is a completely descriptive. You can see like what the Lord holds in hands, in both the hands, Chanka Chakra, Gada and Pankaja. You will see how the Kriti goes.
Sweet. शङ्खचक्र गदपद्मवन मलो शङ्खचक्र गद पद्मवन मलो वेणुगान लोलो कृपाल कङ्कन केयूर मातुडम कङ्कन केयूर मातुडम रमणीय
Also, he says the place where the deity is mentioned, Guru Pavana Purisha. So that is Guruvayur. And what all he holds? Sangha Chakra Gada Padma. So that is what he holds in all the four hands. Sangha Chakra Gada and Padma. So this is also a very, Charan gives a very good description of the Lord Guruvayur. The next slide, please. From this Kriti, we come to know his influence while staying in the Kashi, how he has been exposed to a lot of Hindustani music. So this particular song he has composed in the Raga Shiva Pantavarali or Shubha Pantavarali, and it is somewhat similar to Raga Todi in Hindustani music.
Yeah.
Resembles a Hindustani raga, is a little bit slow paced and almost resembling the raga todi of Hindustani. And this is also a description how one thing unique about this, we see how he has traveled up to Badri, maybe along with Chidambaranath Yogi, but he has kept everything in mind and he has composed this song at a later date. The next slide, please. So this is a very unique song in Raga Tarangini. So here we see some sort of Alankara patterns. He has studied Alankara Shastra, and with that, how he brings about the Alankara patterns in this particular Kriti. First, I will just sing it and then we'll see. just by looking at the words mayi, tvam, yahi, mam, look at it, maybe many of you, what sort of words are these, what description it is, but as a Sanskrit scholar, he has given a lot of meaning into this composition. Philosopher face of Muthuswami Dikshita. So if you see the words it is going on decreasing. At a direct look, it seems as though it doesn't have any meaning, but actually if you see it, sarasakaya means O one whose form is charming. Rasakaya means O one whose body is the rasa itself. Sakaya, O one who has taken a form. Aye, of course, the Supreme Goddess itself to the devotees. So this Pallavi is addressed to Maya, the aspect of divinity which ensnares us in this world, while the rest of the Kriti is addressed to the Divine Mother. So this is a very unique Kriti, and he has chosen the Raga name also appropriately, Tarangani, Raga Tarangani. Tarangani means waves. So this composition itself has some semblance of that. So this form pattern he uses is known as the Gopuchayati, that is a set of syllables which get smaller and smaller. So this is a very unique composition. So next Kriti, please. So now we come towards the last days of Dikshita. We have traveled extensively to different places along with him. So towards the end, when he has composed the song in Madurai, Meenakshi Memudam, on the way to Ettayapuram. So well, at Ettayapuram, he felt that the last days has come, and he had a vision of Goddess Annapurneshwari of Kashi. And he knew, and at that particular time, he told all his disciples to sit beside him and to sing the song Meenakshi Memudam in the Raga Gamaka Kriya. And when they sang the part Meena Lochani, Pasha Mochani, that is the time when he was supposed, his soul is said to have departed. So with this, we come to end of the travel along with Dikshita. But before, I would just like to summarize the whole thing. As I said, Dikshita as a genius. So first you see his usage of Sanskrit, his mastery over the language. Dikshita's use of Sanskrit, and next as a Vainika, Then, if you see, he has used a lot of gamakas in this kriti. Say the example of the todi kriti which I sang. If you are singing the same thing without the sahita, only swarams, and do it akara, then you will get a beautiful picture of the raga todi itself. So that is the way he has composed. Of course, with the sahitya, it elevates it to a different level altogether. Then the musical raga, each raga he has, so composition he has composed, he has used the appropriate raga, and also in his kriti he has brought about the bhava of that particular raga. The sahitya also, if I said, like they take the example of Mama Pattabhi Rama, how he has used the sahitya to the best effect. As a scholar, when you see Muthuswami Dixit as a scholar, the use of the mantra and tantra which he learned from Chidambaranatha Yogi, he has imbibed it in all his Navavarna Kritis. As a philosopher, the song which I just sang, Mayetvam, he has brought that sort of mood into that composition. And of course, he is the pilgrim eternal. He is only composer, he is the composer compared to the all the other Tyagarajas as well as Shamasri. He has traveled extensively from Rameshwaram, where he has composed the Ramanatham Bhaje, now up till Badrinath, where he has composed Sri Satyanarayana. He has been an extensive traveler. So his compositions reveal visual pictures of our heritage, and that is unparalleled even to this day. So not only singing his composition, but listening to his compositions also will give us a unique fulfillment. So with this, I would like to wind up with one of his Mangala Kritis, Navavarna Mangala Kritis in the Rashri Raga. Yeah, that's the song.
Shri Pati Vimute Sita Sita
Before I go in for the question answer session, my sincere thanks to Shruti Laya for giving me this opportunity to share my thoughts on Muthuswami Deekshithar with everyone. My thanks to special thanks to the Shruti Laya team who did the posters and others who gave publicity for to this program, and thanks to one and all who are present here, take the time off to be here present for the program. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you, ma'am. That was a very good session. It was great. And the way you explained everything, it was really beautiful.
Thank you.
And the way you sung it, it was just perfect. The volume and everything. And the way you presented it, it was actually divine. So thanks a lot for that. And now, yes. So there was a question which Vivek put forward, which was,
before you start the question session, I'll just like to say,
yes,
see, of course, music is an ocean. Whatever I know is just a drop in that ocean, maybe a not a drop. I'll try to answer to the best of my level. If not, I'll definitely come back to them with the answer. Okay?
Yes, ma'am, definitely. So Vivek asks, is Kalyani exactly the same as Yaman in Hindustani, or is there some difference?
Yeah. So I would say Kalyani is not the same as Yaman, because as you say, the Pakkad or in Hindustani Pakkad or in Carnatic music, we call Kalyani, we call it as Mecha Kalyani. It is a Melakarta Raga. So Melakarta has got certain rules to be followed. It should be from Sa to Sa. Star, it cannot from Da to higher Da, or Ni to Ni, it cannot come. It has to start from the Shadja up to the other higher Shadja, and all the Swaras which are going should be the same in the coming. Arohan and Avrohan should be same. And whatever the swaras are there in the Arohan, the same swara should be in Avrohan. In the case of Yaman, there is a particular pakkad which is very prominent in Hindustani music, starting from Ni. So that is very prominent. So it is also there in Kalyani, we it say, but we use it very rarely. But our Arohan itself starts from Sa to Sa. So that is why I say it's similar. I would not see the same. There may be similar points, but not the same.
Yes, ma'am. So the next question was by Niharika,
yeah,
who asked that why does Muthuswami Deekshithar use the Guru Guha Mudra instead of his own name like Tyagaraja?
See, each one, there must be a reason for having their own mudra. So in the case of Tyagaraja, he uses the Tyagaraja only. In the case of Shama Sastri, he uses Shama Krishna Nuta, Shama Krishna Sahodri, like that. In the case of Swadhi Tirunal, if you see another composer, Maharaja Swadhi Tirunal, he uses all synonyms of Padmanabha. Padmanabha, Sarasvatinabha, or whatever is pertaining, synonymous to that same word, he uses as a mudra. So in the case of Guru Guha, his first composition was in Tirthani, where he meditated for 41 days and he got the blessings. So Guha is another name for God, Lord Subramanya, and he considered him as the Guru. So his teacher Guru. So therefore, I feel he must have made use of Guru Guha as his mudra.
Ma'am, after me, I think Gautam had a few questions to ask you.
Yeah.
So, over to Gautam.
Yeah, Gautam.
Gautam.
Hello, ma'am. Can you hear me? So I had a question about so the Trinity like Tyagaraja, Shyamasastri, and Dikshita. So are there any stylistic differences between their compositions that we can hear while listening to their compositions?
One thing you can differentiate, of course, by the mudras. Another thing is the language used by them. Tyagaraja has used Sanskrit and Telugu. Shyamashastri also Sanskrit, Telugu, and a few Tamil Krithis. Dikshidhar, 99% in Sanskrit itself. There are just one or two compositions in Telugu. So, and also the approach to the thing. If you see Tyagaraja, he is always yearning to be with Lord Rama. So his compositions are sort of beseeching. That sort of mood is there in the composition. Shyamashastri is one-to-one. He was Archaka in the temple and to the goddess. So it is a one-to-one sort of talking to goddess Kamachi itself. His compositions are like that. And of course, here in the case of Dikshidhar, we see his as you say, he does not instantaneously compose, maybe in very rare cases, but he used to go to a temple, he would go around the prahara, he will sit on the in front of the god or goddess, and then maybe meditate for some time, and then think over the go see what are the festivals celebrated, what is something unique, and then later on put together all in his compositions. So I think by even reading two, three compositions, you can come to know what whose composition is what. And also, yes, and some like Dikshidhar, Shyamashastri, they have put some swaras, sahityas into their compositions. Swaras are there, but Tyagaraja has not. Of course, Tyagaraja has composed that Pancharatna Kirtanas, which has got swara as well as sahityas. So by listening to more kritis, you can definitely make out the difference.
Thank you, ma'am. Also, I had a question about the Navagraha Kritis. So, for I think Surya, there's Saurashtra. So, is there like a particular mapping for a Navagraha and their Kriti? Is there a reason why he chose Saurashtra for Surya, that kind of
Yeah,
thing?
it is. Yes, there is. He has. There is something. Maybe the mood of the song, the mood of the song, or whatever it is. It and even the raga is finally the way you sing it, and the vibrations you get while singing the same. All this must be imbibed by him into the kritis. By studying the kritis itself, we get a lot of information. Is that was answer your question, Gautam?
और
वाईफाई गुड या
डॉक्टर मेनी अदर क्वेश्चन
Yes, ma'am. There's one question from Vaibhav. He wants to know how is Carnatic form of singing distinctive in itself, which makes it different from Hindustani music?
See, before, as I've explained before the 13th century, it was just Indian music. Because the influence above the Vindhyas and below the Vindhyas, if you separate it, there has not been much of disturbance historically. But if you see North India, there has been a lot of invasions, and because of that, those influence has affected the music. So deeper down south, it has affected a certain extent, but not completely like how it has been. So we have an influence of the Arabic and Persian influence also over there in the North Hindustani music. The swaras are the same in whichever music you take. The Saptaswaras swaras are the same, but the approach to the swaras are different. That is me. And the phrases, suppose we do the raga alap, we sometimes just to dist in the beginning of a concert, just to distinguish the song, we give a complete fast number of phrases so that the person listening to it can immediately connect to the raga. Whereas in Hindustani, it is always a very slow development from one swara to another swara, and the development is very slow. We can in Carnatic music, we can have even sometimes very slow development, but we also have a very fast development of the raga. So in the concerts. So I think this could be only the approach to the swaras and how it is sung, it is different. Otherwise, the same. Mangalas are there in both.
Thank you, ma'am. Also, there's like not exactly a question, but a request from Janani. She'd like a Kriti that is an example of Western music influence.
Yeah, that is the notice for us there, Western music. What he heard at Fort St. George, this is a, whatever he heard at Fort St. George, that he, and he heard it at a very small age, but the Nottaswara he composed only around 1832. He passed away 1835. So at very later years only he has composed that. The tune must have been his mind. So because of that, he has composed most of it are in Shankarabharanam, not all, but most of it are in Shankarabharanam Ratha, which is also the scale, major C in Western music. Therefore, he has composed about 38 to 40 Nottaswaras, which are very simple, and actually it is taught to the beginners who are into studying music after the foundation lessons. They are introduced after Gitam. They are introduced into this small Nottaswaras, which is the only difference. Even though the tune could be identical to that of Western note, the lyrics is completely in Sanskrit, which makes it unique.
Thank you, ma'am. I think those are all the questions we have. So,
okay.
Thank you so much for coming to this lecture, ma'am. It was very fun and we learned a lot as well. And in fact, I myself as a Hindustani classical connoisseur, I started listening to a lot more of Carnatic as well, thanks to this lecture.
Gautam, have you taken the subject, Carnatic music, for your elective course? No.
Not yet, ma'am, but I plan.
Okay.
So, yes, ma'am, thank you so much for giving us your precious time.
Thank you very much. Thank you, one and all. A good day to all of you all. Keep safe during this pandemic. Anyway, it was a nice, enjoyable evening for me discussing music with all of you. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. And I'd also like to thank Anushka for the wonderful anchoring. And I'd also like to thank everybody who joined this meet to make it an unqualified success. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you.